Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series on food and cosmetic analysis. In this 12th video, you are going to learn about introduction of coffee, commercially important species of coffee, and composition of green and roasted C. arabica beans of coffee. And last is the role of kauri in coffee. So these are the coffee beans. Every day we are taking coffee. Here today we are going to see some important aspect of the coffee powder. So basically this is the tea from which the coffee powder is prepared. So basically the coffee is prepared from the coffee beans, and this is the plant from which the coffee beans are collected. So these are the fruits of coffee beans. Some more closer view. So these are the fruit of coffee beans, and these are the actual beans. So when it is opened and when it is dried and roasted, it form a coffee beans, and the powder of this coffee beans become a coffee powder. So basically coffee beans contain caffeine. Caffeine is responsible for stimulating effect of the drink. Coffee also contains polyphenols, which are responsible for the bitterness of coffee. Caffeine is present in the coffee beans in both free and combined state. Commercially important species of coffee are coffee arabica, coffee robusta, and coffee librica. So these are the three main species of coffee which are commercially available: librica, robusta, and arabica. There is a slight change in a fruit of a coffee beans. So here we can see the closer view. This is the coffee beans of a species arabica. This is a coffee bean of a species robusta, and this is a coffee beans of species librica. So these three are the important commercially available species of a coffee beans. So here we are going to see the composition of green and roasted C. arabica beans. Grams of 100 of coffee beans. So we are going to see the composition of the coffee beans specifically for this green and roasted C. arabica beans. So this table shows the various constituents which are present in a coffee beans of a green and roasted of arabica species. So the different constituents which are present in a coffee beans are moisture, protein, fat, sugar, dextrose, ash, caffeine, and chlorogenic acid. So the green and roasted species of coffee arabica contain different percentage. So basically you can see the main difference of a moisture in a green and roasted. So in a green bean there is a 8.98% of a moisture, but in roasted it can lower to 0.63%. so definitely there is a decrease in a moisture content or water content because it is roasted. Some other parameters like proteins, fat, sugar, dextrose, ash, caffeine, and chlorogenic acid are present in a both form, in green as well as roasted form. Only there is a difference in a change in their percentage. The several organic acids are present in aqueous extract of coffee beans. During roasting, formic acid and acetic acid content are increased, and chlorogenic acid like citric acid and malic acid are destroyed. Coffee also contains kauri. So here if you see the constituent of the coffee beans, they contain chlorogenic acid nearly about 8.46% in green form and nearly 4.74% in roasted form. So during the process, some of the acid are destroyed, because of that their percentage are decreased. So coffee also contains kauri, which is the main constituents that we are going to see in detail. So here we will see the role of kauri in coffee. Kauri is a part of coffee plant, used is root, which chopped, roasted, and grounded. It is well known substitute for coffee blending. So here if you see the percentage, nearly 50% of a coffee powder is containing kauri. What is kauri? Kauri is a plant, coffee plant part, It is actually root which is chopped, roasted and grounded, and then it is mixed in a coffee beans powder. This kauri gives bitterness to the coffee, which is find refreshing. So here we'll see the detail. So these are the roots of a coffee plants. So these roots of a coffee plants are chopped. Fine or small pieces of roots of plants are made, and this chopped root are dried and it's converted into powder form, and then its powders are mixed with the coffee beans. Here we can see the percentage, it is nearly 50%. So the which is very important constituents of this coffee powder. So kauri having very important role in coffee for making its bitter. So in this video you have learned about introduction of coffee, commercially important species of coffee, composition of two species like green and roasted C. arabica beans, and finally we discuss about the role of kauri in the coffee. So please learn next topic of this unit in my next video. Till then, I thank you all of you for watching this video. I wish you a happy e-learning.